Hey, Rodriguezors and Swifties, or just people. Hello. Today is May 28th, 2021, and welcome to another album reaction. So today I'll be hearing Sour by Olivia Rodrigo for the first time. Now, I wasn't originally planning to do a reaction to this album, but as you can see, this album is already breaking records already, and it's Olivia's debut album. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna have to see what this album has in store, because I have a good feeling about it. What is the fandom name going to be called? I was thinking about it. I was thinking like Rodriguezors, like dinosaur, and like Rodrigo, like her last name, Rodriguezors. But then I feel like that's too long. I'm just gonna say Rodriguezors, okay? But yes, if you're here for the reaction, I need to say a couple things before we get into the album reaction. So if you're here for the reaction, this is the timestamp. But yes, as you can see, this is the usual setting I have for videos, but I'm currently sitting on a chair right now. There's no bed for me to sit on because I'm currently in the process of moving upstairs. So hold on, let me show you. All right, so as you can see, there's a whole bunch of stuff just everywhere. I got some books, and then this is an organizer I need to eventually set up. There's some backpack, there's a guitar. Maybe I should do more stuff with that this year, but I don't know. Maybe I will, but we'll see. I got some posters, got some old textbooks. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And it's gonna be like this for I don't know how long. I need to get around to doing this.
So, as you can see, this room will be a work in progress, but I'll eventually get around to doing that. Also, the songs that I have heard on this album are Driver's License. Of course, that song is everywhere in 2021. And also Deja Vu. Apparently, her newest single, Good For You, is apparently better than Deja Vu and Driver's License. But before we get into the reaction, please check out the links in the description for Nepal and India and their COVID crisis, as well as Colombia and their government situation going right now. And also, I will also include some links about how to help Palestine. That's the whole situation. I will also include a link about how to donate and help and information about that. But without further ado, let's go ahead and listen to the first one. It is called Brutal. Let's go ahead and listen to it. I don't know what I was expecting, but it was not this. Dude, what kind of Paramore is this? I've also heard that Good For You is also kind of Paramore-ish, or like kind of like rock-ish. So what I'm gathering so far, I guess the adolescent experience or like teenage experience and how other people tend to set up their own expectations and put it onto you. Is that what it is? Because she was saying like, where is my teenage dream? Like, this isn't what I thought adolescence was going to be. Okay, interesting. I only have two real friends, and lately I'm a nervous wreck, cause I love people I don't like, and I hate every song I write, and I'm not cool, and I'm not smart, and I can't even tell apart. All I did was okay, that was Brutal. That was the first song. I really like how the title of the song kind of matches with the instrumental or the production of the song, because it's like very like dun 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 dun. It's brutal, if you will. Well, I thought it was a good opening to the album. But yes, let's go ahead and go on to the next song. The next song is called Traitor. I almost forgot to mention, I have tissues with me just in case. Let's really hope I don't need to use those tissues.
But you talked to her, maybe did it even worse. I kept quiet so I could keep you. Now it sure as hell don't look like you betrayed.
What did she say? All the questions you used to avoid. Ain't it funny? Remember, I brought her up and you told me I was paranoid. You betrayed me, thinking that there's something else going on. You're just overreacting. There's nothing going on. You traitor. I really like how this song is composed. I really like this one so far. The songwriting in that song, I have a feeling that song is already gonna be one of the favorites for me. Traitor, dude, I really like that song. Oh, Olivia, how are we feeling? Am I going to be okay by the last song? I don't know. Wow, Traitor, that song extremely impressed me. Wow, that was a really good song. Okay, but without further ado, let's go on to the next song. So the next song is Driver's License. We have already heard that song. I will include some footage here of that reaction.
Hello, today is January 12th, 2021. I am going to react to Driver's License by Olivia Rodrigo. So let's hear Driver's License by Olivia Rodrigo.
And I just can't imagine how you could be so Street.
That was the song. Wow. I really like it. I really like the song. Oh my gosh. I had so many chills. Her voice reminds me a lot of Halsey. Just like a little bit. Actually kind of a lot. But this is just her debut song. I'm sure she hasn't really released that much music. Yeah, this is her debut song. Wow, I really like it. Yeah, I am thoroughly impressed. Her vocals were on point, her production was good. The lyrics, especially substantial. There is depth. There is a meaning behind it, and I really appreciate it.
Yes, so that was Driver's License, and the next song is called One Step Forward, Three Steps Back. I also heard this has, she sampled New Year's Day on this song, the piano. Reputation is the all-time favorite Taylor Swift album. Reputation was such a time. I don't know if anything will top it. Well, I don't know if I want to go that far, but... Anyway, let's go ahead and hear this song. Bye, I already like it.
Called you on the phone today, just to ask you how you are. I'm the love of your life until I make you mad. It's always one step forward and three steps. all I've ever had. There is one step for...
Hold on. It's back and forth, baby. This is all your fault instead. It's one step forward and three steps back. And I'd leave you, but the roller coaster is all I've ever had. Oh my gosh. Roller coaster, I'm in terms of, or I guess like in, within the context of the song, I'm assuming that that would mean a lot of ups and downs in the relationship. So maybe this is saying how much she's used to the ups and downs in the relationship. And it would be difficult for her to leave this person because they have not experienced anything else. Is that a stretch? I do not know. Anyway.
Boy, I don't understand. No, I don't understand.
Okay, so that was one step forward, three steps back. That song was okay. That song was good. It's also under 3 minutes as well. Yeah, I don't really have that much to say about it. I did like the sample of the New Year's Day in the song. I thought it was a really good addition to the song. But yes, let's go ahead and listen to the next song. The next song is called Deja Vu. Insert a little bit of the reaction here.
Hello. Today is April 1st, 2021. Yeah, let's go ahead and hear this song first. It's called Deja Vu. It's explicit, just like driver's license. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 6 songs on this upcoming album that are going to be explicit. What is this going to sound like? I don't know. I'm highly intrigued. But without further ado, let's listen to the song, Deja Vu.
Strawberry ice cream, 1 spoon for 2, and trading jackets. Laughing about how small it looks on you.
That reminded me of Taylor Swift so much. Yeah, it looks so pretty like a devil and it's too... It reminds me of Cruel Summer. This song is giving me Cruel Summer. Oh my gosh. She truly is a Swiftie, huh? It's just giving me like summer... A summer feel to it. I like it. Wow. Actually, let me turn the light on because it's kind of dark. That's better, I think. Yeah. Shall we watch the video, okay? Before this video gets too long.
So when you gonna tell that it's all we used, that was the show we talked about, played you the song she's singing now when she's with you. Do you get deja vu when she's with you?
Wait. The whole meaning of the song just changed just now. At first, I was thinking she's talking to another guy that they moved on from each other. Because in the first scene, she goes up to this house and then she sees this girl in a green dress, which I'm now assuming is her ex's new girlfriend. And she's like, I wonder if you think about the stuff that we used to do together, but now you're doing it with this new girl. And it's all reused. We've all already done this. It's not anything new. You and I have already been through this. She's not special. Do you get... Well, I don't know if that's... I might be, like, overstepping a little bit, but... And then with this new scene, it's Olivia and the girl in the green dress, and it's just the two of them. And now I'm thinking, wait, the meaning of the song is changing. I think it is, at least. If you're like thinking the same way I am, you're thinking Olivia's talking about her ex-BF that she moved on from. But now it seems like she's talking to the girl in the green dress, thinking how they used to do everything together. Either friends, best friends, or lovers, maybe? I don't know. She got me. She tricked me. Okay, let's keep watching. Cruel Summer.
I was the one who taught you baby girl. And
We destroy televisions now. Plot twist. Whoa, that was really good. Oh, I might like this song better than Driver's License. I don't know. Driver's License is still good though, but I think I have a new favorite now. That song was good, and the video and the concept behind it was so clever and interesting. It kept me engaged. Like, I'm trying to know what happens next. Oh, what's her fan base called? I want to be a part of her fan base now. I am a part of the fan base. I'm deep within it now. You can't get rid of me. I'm not leaving. I'm a part of the fan base now. Yes. Without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and end the video. Bye.
So, that was Deja Vu. It's still one of the favorite songs. I really like Deja Vu. But we are going to go ahead and listen to the next song. The next song is called Good For You. This song debuted at number one. It's her third single. I'm going to watch the video too. But let's listen to the song.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl.
This song is giving me angsty vibes. Like, this song is like giving me the imagery of like you're mad at your partner, so you're going to go to their apartment, throw their stuff out the window, make a mess of their apartment, go find their car, slash their tires, just make their life miserable. This is what this song is giving me, this type of energy. But what I'm gathering so far from this song is good for you that you're doing well now that you moved on from me, and good for you that you're happy and that you're healthy. I've been drinking coffee. I've been eating healthy. You know what? I'm gonna stop. But it doesn't feel like the singer or like the perspective of the person singing the song is necessarily happy for the person. It sounds more like petty, I guess, or I guess more unresolved, like, good for you, you've moved on from me. I'm glad to see that you're doing well, but you left me like this. Yeah, it doesn't really seem like the feeling is mutual between both parties. That's just what I'm gathering so far. I might be wrong.
For you, I guess you moved on really easily.
Okay, I need to see what the visual looks like for this song. Wait a minute. I want to watch this video. Dude, I've been avoiding this song and the video for about a week. This is a week later after the album has released. I really like the rock kind of element, or like the alternative sound to the song. I like it. Oh, so wow, the video was released 2 weeks ago. It has 60 million views. Wow, okay. Let's watch it real fast. Oh, is that phone? Yeah. Get your money.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world?
Going to get a progression with this video, because it's from the beginning it looked like, oh, she's kind of normal, and then it kind of like when she shoved that girl in the locker room, like is she the mean and popular girl, or is that what she's trying to portray? And now she's in the store, which I think she's getting gasoline or getting the angry X, I suppose. Anyway, let's keep watching. Again, popcorn and gasoline. You are not slick, man. What you doing?
Bored, so I ruined lunch purposely. And I had fun doing it.
Olivia. I really like the 2000s kind of vibe, or like the look to the video. Okay. I feel like the video has definitely heightened the liking I have for Good For You. I'm still not quite there yet. I need to give it a couple more listens, but the song is... It's going to be a grower for me. But yeah, let's go ahead and listen to the next song. The next song is called Enough For You.
I won't make up when we dated, 'cause I thought you'd like me more. If I looked like the other prom queens, I know that you loved before. Tried so hard to be everything that you liked, just for you to say you're not the compliment type. Before you found someone more exciting, the next second you were gone. And you left me there crying and wondering what I did wrong.
Dude. Who hurt Olivia Rodrigo? She is like emulating so many emotions right now with this song. It's just a broken heart and a really talented songwriter, like the best. Either such a good combination or like a really toxic combination, because you could like write about anything. I wonder if she has songwriting credits for this entire album. She might, but I'll have to do more research on that. All right, let's keep listening to Enough For You.
Enough for you. No, nothing's enough for you.
Wow, Olivia. That's also a song that I really like. That one's really good. Also, can we not, like, I understand the message of the song. Like, I'm not good enough for you. I'm not enough for you. I want to be this for you, but it will never be enough. I will never satisfy you. It shouldn't be. I'm putting in all this energy, all this effort to make you like me, or to see that I would be a good match for you. There has to be a balance between that. It can't just be one person giving and giving and giving, and then the other person just consuming and consuming. I really like her songwriting in that one. That one, the lyrics of that song really stood out to me. But let's go ahead and go on to the next song. The next song is called Happier.
We broke up a month ago. Your friends are mine, you know. I know you've moved on, found someone new. You meant it when you said it first to me. And now I'm picking.
Wait. I really like how she said that. Hold on.
First to me.
Orchestral arrangement is getting me. Yeah. Happier. I don't know. I don't have much to say on it quite yet.
I hope you're happy, but don't be happier.
I hope that you're happy, but don't be happier. Is that meaning like, don't be happy, but don't be happy? You can be happy, but don't be happier. You can still be, like, once we move on from each other, like, I like to see you do well, but I don't want to see you be happier than me, because it's like, All right, so that was Happier, and the next song is called Jealousy.
But it feels like that weight is on my back, and I can't let it go. Comparison. Thank you.
No, because you're right. No, I get that. I can definitely see her perspective of, like, I'm tired of everyone seeing, like, everyone living this seemingly put together life. Everyone's on vacation, everyone's got the new kind of fashion. I don't want to feel jealousy, and I shouldn't feel it, but I do. As sad as it is, I feel like I'm kind of desensitized to the seemingly perfect social media world. Because do I know that it's real? It's hard. Anyway, let's keep listening. Okay, that was Jealousy, Jealousy. I feel like that song was also a grower for me. I didn't really quite connect with it. It was okay. Let's go ahead and go on to the next song. The next song is called Favorite Crime.
Know that I love you so bad. I let you treat me like that. I was your willing accomplice, honey. Oh, look what we became.
No, that song was too short. I just got lost in the song. I don't even think I said anything. No, I don't know, but like the theme of the song is like reminding me of Getaway Car. Put the money in the back and I stole the key. That was the last time you ever saw me. You're driving in a getaway car. Don't pretend it's such a mystery. Think about the place where you first met me. Dude, I really like that song. Ooh, Favorite Crime. The song was really good. Okay, anyway, so we have one more song left to listen to. It is Hope You're Okay. Now, I've definitely heard a lot of, I guess, not really criticism, but a lot of feedback over the song. But we'll listen to it first, and then maybe I can get a better understanding of what the feedback was. But let's listen to the last song. The last song is called Hope You're Okay. I'm not gonna be okay after this song, I know that.
When I was small, a towhead blonde with eyes of salt, he played the drum in the marching band. We don't talk much, but I just gotta say, I miss you. I hope that you're okay. I trust the letters to the holes in my body.
This is reminding me of Lord with an E so much. Oh, it's just giving me so much Lord energy right now. This is also reminding me of The Story by Conan. Just like with the storytelling a lot. But anyway, let's keep listening.
God, I hope that you're happier today. Cause I love you. I hope that you're okay.
Oh, Olivia. Oh, man. I'm a little teary-eyed. I am. Wow. That was the closing track to Sour by Olivia Rodrigo. Now, how does the album title correlate to the songs? I do feel like the album is quite cohesive. Nothing really felt out of place. They all sounded like they belong on this album. What I was mentioning earlier about this song. So I saw this post where people were saying like how this might have been a bad or not the best decision for Olivia to, for her to write a song about an experience that is not hers. Like she was mentioning about this boy who had blonde hair and played drums in the marching band, and his parents cared more about the Bible than they cared for their own child. And he wore a long sleeve because of his dad. I'm not really quite sure what that means yet, but and people were saying, like, she's not even speaking from experience, and that might have not been the best decision. I can only hope that Olivia reached out to some of the people she mentioned. But then again, it's very vague and it's not really, she didn't write it to exploit them. It's just their stories, the two people, or I think three people that she might have mentioned, which is more significant. And then other people were saying Olivia is being a good role model and she is telling these stories through her song and people or her fans can look up to and realize that they're not the only ones experiencing it, which I am more on that side of things. I'd like to hope that there's some kind of permission or like some kind of notice so she didn't just like write the song and be like, I don't know, that's not really, I don't really feel comfortable with that. I don't really feel okay with that. But yeah, that's all I have to say about that. I thought it was a pretty good debut album. It'll definitely take some time for me to grow, for me to eventually get connected with it. But the songs that I really connected with were Traitor, Deja Vu, Enough For You, Favorite Crime, and Hope You're Okay. But yeah, I thought it was a pretty decent album. I really liked it. So, with that said, thank you so much for watching. And what songs on this album did you really like? Which of the three singles did you really like? Driver's License, Deja Vu, or Good For You? I don't know. I still like Driver's License, even though it's overplayed on the radio a lot. But that happens with every song that is promoted as a single. It's going to get overplayed and people are not going to like it anymore. But yes, thank you again for watching. Please check out those links in the description. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.